Time for part two of week 16's presentation. Part two is on installing hardware in the guitar. We're going to start by talking about some holes that we need to drill before we can get that hardware mounted. First one I want to talk about is the through hole. And remember those terms, major and minor diameter. The through hole in wood is equal to or a frog hair bigger than the major diameter. If you do it that way and it's the same size, you're going to have to maybe tap it through or push it through. If it's just a little bit larger, it might slip through. And this is important. We want some places, we want the screw just to go through, and we do not want the threads to grip the wood. One place where that's the case is in the neck pocket of your guitar. There are four holes that will drill through from back to front in the neck pocket from mounting the neck. Those must be through holes. Otherwise, if the thread is grabbing the body, you might not get a tight, snug fit of the root of the neck into the neck pocket. So through holes in the neck pocket. We also have pilot holes that are important. Again, that terminology, a pilot hole is a hole drilled equal to or slightly larger than the minor diameter. And the reason for this is that that wedge at the tip, if we don't have a pilot hole and we just drive it in, or if we drill too small of a pilot hole, the wedge tip will split the wood, and two things might happen. One, it might crack the wood from forcing it apart, or that wood might grip so firmly on the screw that you won't be able to drive it any further. It'll be trapped, and you might snap off the head or strip out the head of the screw. Snap the head off or strip it out. And these, where we're going to use pilot holes, well, pretty much for all of our wood screws going directly into wood, but in particular, the back side of the root of the guitar's neck, those are pilot holes. And typically what you want to do is you want to use a pilot drill chart. But I want to show you something here real quick. Here is the screw that is going to go. Let me see if I can get it in focus here. I might not be able to get close enough to make this worthwhile, but I want to at least illustrate something, and you might be able to try it yourself at home. You can see, I hope, the threads, which are the major diameter, and the shank there, the minor diameter. Now for the through hole, here's how I do it. I take and I hold a drill bit over top of the threads, and if I can't see the threads, then I know I'm large enough. I don't want it to be too big, so I'll turn around and take a look at it like this, and I'll also feel and make sure that I've got the right size bit for a through hole for my screw. In this case, this guy is 3/16 diameter. So make note of that for drilling the through hole in the neck pocket. For the pilot hole, we want the screw to be, we want the drill size to be the size of the minor diameter. And again, I eyeball this, and this is gonna be hard to see on camera, but what I do is I hold this up, looking at the bit, holding it in front of the threads. And if I can see the threads on both sides of the bit, then I know I've got a good size. If I put up too small of a bit in front of the screw and I see some of the shank, I know that pilot bit is too small. So I start small and I work my way up, and then I can see just when I get the right size that's hiding the shank in there where the minor diameter is. And in this case, we will be using a 7/64 bit for our pilot hole on our neck. But again, there are pilot drill charts, and those charts will even tell you the difference if it's a softwood or a hardwood. So that's something to pay attention to there. Now there's another kind of screw hole we're not going to be too concerned about here. It's the thread hole. This is important when you are drilling and tapping metal to accept a machine screw or a bolt. So we're not going to be doing that in STEM guitar class. If you do, you should absolutely consult a drill chart for machine screws. They'll tell you exactly what size hole to drill before you tap your threads. Now, washers are often used behind the head of a screw if it's got a flat back, and also between the nut and whatever it's clamping against. And what this does is it spreads the clamping force so you get fewer pounds per square inch. You still have the same force holding the materials together, but fewer PSI pushing on the material itself. And in, with wood especially, if you have a high PSI, you're going to puncture right into the wood. So by having washers, it spreads the force out on the surface and it won't damage the wood that you're attaching. Now, we do have our neck plate, for example, is just a big giant four-hole washer. And if you think about it, the bridge itself sort of has its own built-in washer and spreads the force so that we're not driving the bridge down into the wood itself and creating problems. One of the nice things about washers is makes it easy to take apart later also when you're done. So washers are important. Another thing is that's important is lubricant. We have to lubricate the threads, especially on the hardwood. If you don't, that wood might grip so tight, again, you might snap the screw or strip the head. There are commercial thread waxes. I've used beeswax, although I find that a little stiff and gummy. But one that I really like is ivory bar soap. You get a bar of ivory soap and just rub the threads back and forth into the soap, and you'll end up filling the valleys there with good lubricating soap. And another one that works well and is pretty affordable is a toilet bowl wax ring. It's cheap. You just dip the screw into the wax ring and your threads are lubricated. Now, also important, proper screw driving technique. Since most of the screws we're using have a Phillips type head, it's very important. You have to apply a pretty fair amount of inline force, straight in line with the direction of the screw, straight from the head down into the wood. So for example, if you are using a drill driver, a mechanical driver, you want to make sure you put your hand on the back side of that battery operated driver and you want to push straight down into the screw, pushing it into the wood before you pull the trigger on that thing. Same thing with a hand screwdriver. Put the palm of your hand on the butt of the screwdriver and push straight down into the screw before you start turning the screw. If you don't have enough inline force, it's that bit's going to spin, it's going to strip the head, and you're going to damage the bit. Not good. Seen too many students do that. Now that we've talked about all this hardware stuff all this threaded fastener stuff and how to lube the threads and how to drive the screws, once your body is finished, you've got it painted and oil finished, once that's all done, it's time to install hardware on the body. And here's the order. String ferrules first into the back of the body. Those don't require a screwdriver. They require a mallet and you can do it without the little special driving tool, but we do have a special tool for driving those in. Once those are in, you want to install the control harness into the electronics pocket, and then you can push the knobs onto your tone and volume controls. You want to properly assemble the pickup rings and pickups. You got to pay attention. The back side of the pickups will say bridge or neck. The one that says neck is the one that goes closest to the neck. The one that says bridge goes closest to the bridge. There are little springs and very thin machine screws that assemble the frames or rings to the pickup. And boy, those springs will go flying if you don't do this carefully. Make sure you get those assembled first. Then run your wires through the wireways to the electronics pocket. And then you can drill some small pilot holes. And with the screws supplied with the pickup frames, you can attach those to the front of the body. The bridge is a little tricky. Make sure you put the bridge ground wire in first. Next week, I'll do a little video on that, or you might see it in one of the videos linked at the end of this presentation. You got to get your ground wire in first and then screw the bridge down with five screws that are supplied. But again, the metal of these screws is a little soft. good-sized pilot hole, plenty of lube on the threads, and proper technique for driving those screws. And then lastly, install the strap buttons and pick good locations for those. Now, once you've got the hardware in the body, and after the guitar neck is finished, meaning painted or oil painted, and after the nut and frets have been properly installed, now you can install the tuning machines in the headstock and properly attach the neck to the body. You should for sure watch a video on that or wait for face-to-face guidance. After all that is completed, the hardware is all on, the neck is attached to the guitar, and even put strings on the guitar. You don't have a guitar. You have a GSO. That stands for guitar-shaped object. To turn a GSO into a playable guitar, you have to do the full setup procedure. This involves making sure that you've got proper neck relief in the neck, that you've got proper string height at the first fret, proper string height at the 21st fret, that you've got it intonated properly, that there's no fret buzz and all the frets are level. You've got to go through all that whole big process, and once you get that done, then you have a playable guitar. One thing I'd like you to do is start watching, if you haven't done so already, the official STEM guitar videos. You can find some of those at guitarbuilding.org videos. These links are active. And also from there, you can link to their YouTube channel, or you can just type that in and get there with this. I'll put this PowerPoint in the module, and these hyperlinks are active as well. So that's it for this week. Again, summarizing, please do watch for those emails and watch for that update video coming later on today. And I'll be back with you next week. And I need to be hearing back from you on the emails you read and the update that you watch. Please make sure you get back to me with your decision ASAP. And like I said, you've only got a little more than a week to make some critical decisions. Y'all take care, stay healthy, get a little fresh air, but be safe with social distancing and go wash your stinking hands. Take care. Bye-bye.